You guys know those subreddits where people trash the worst UI ever? Can anyone here help me unsubscribe from this email? I mean, does anybody here happen to have bionic vision where you can actually find the unsubscribe link? Do you see it now? Sometimes, I'm a huge nerd, sometimes I scroll through these for a laugh before I go to sleep. Is this for real though? I mean, it's country codes for countries, phone numbers, right? In the alphabetical order of the country without actually writing the name of the country. Some of these are so bad. Now, this one might actually present a real issue if color is the only way you indicate the completed state. So that might be a problem, let's say, if you're colorblind. That's a major social network. People here build such great products. So I hate to be a buzzkill, but those bad UIs are just the tip of the iceberg for what it's like for people with disabilities on your website. I know that there are some very well-paid CTOs and engineers in this audience. You've got a lot of purchasing power. What companies everywhere need to know is that people with disabilities have a lot of economic power too. In the US alone, that's 5 times the purchasing power of Bill Gates. $500 billion. Wow. And worldwide, people with disabilities and their families command over $13 trillion. You guys like shopping? I do. Maybe someone in your life likes shopping, if you don't. 2/3 of e-commerce transactions are abandoned by people with a visual impairment because the checkout is not adequately accessible. So if you're not addressing accessibility on your company website, it might be your loss, literally. And if the business stakes weren't high enough, I think there are some pretty big companies in the room today. I'm guessing you guys have users in Europe, US, global markets. New laws in Europe are now coming out, and they're already being enforced. All these laws say that the checkout flows and your websites, all those barriers that accessibility issues present, are discriminatory and illegal, and you might be subject to fines. Beyond that, your company should care about accessibility because over 1 billion people globally face barriers to an online experience. And today, strangely, no website or platform mandates or forces accessibility before publishing. For example, LinkedIn. When we post, it offers you alt text, but it's optional. It doesn't check that the alt text actually matches what you posted. You know, you could say that this is like, you know, a picture of a dead ant under a magnifying glass in the baking summer sun for all the platform cares. Same with website building platforms. What I'm saying is that if you want your digital experiences to be consistently accessible, it's totally on your team. And if it's not on your dev team, it's going to be on your legal team. Look to your left, look to your right. The person sitting next to you might have an invisible disability. Think about dyslexia, ADHD. Someone might have low vision because they're maybe older than you. Except me, I'm much, much younger and I can prove it with my birth date selector right here. But some of you are old enough to remember mobile first, right? Today we're seeing more and more companies go accessibility first. This helps ensure a simple, intuitive UI and functional UX for your products. So hopefully today I've convinced you to pay attention to accessibility. But what should you do about it? Don't wait. Thinking about accessibility in production is probably already too late. Accessibility is a newer industry. You know, in the past, you have to pay consultants, do it manually, find out what you're doing wrong with audits, and not be sure what to do about it. And in the last few years, you've been able to buy aftermarket software that you pop on your site and it starts remediating your code right on the page load. Millions of websites out there use my company's software for that. So what I'm saying is you got 2 ways of doing accessibility. One way is, like I said, after you launch your website, you can do automated remediation right in the browser. But now, you're doing much more accessibility work in the source code rather than on your website after it's published. This means accessibility is shifting left, and that's a really good thing. Everyone in this room knows that certain things are non-negotiables. A prenup, for example. But more importantly, GDPR, cybersecurity, QA. Accessibility is one of those things, but a lot of people do not know a lot about it just yet. For one thing, accessibility is kind of like GDPR. It's about compliance. Just like you can set and forget your cookie solution for GDPR, there are parts of accessibility that can and should be put on autopilot. It's also like cybersecurity in that it's about risk. And actually, maybe this is a better reference for this security-focused crowd. You can think about accessibility violations like bugs, some more serious than others, others showstoppers. And if you think about them like bugs, you can do whatever it is you guys all do with bugs. The work never ends, does it? And finally, think about how you do automated testing. This is how I think about you doing automated testing when I think about you doing automated testing. So my alt text for this is an image of a coder with his back to the camera sitting at a desk in a shadow in front of three vertical computer screens with glowing lines of code cascading down the monitors. So you have multiple browsers, multiple operating systems, tons of different environments for your site. Do you work with React, mobile platforms, web apps? That's what makes ensuring accessibility expensive. We can change that code, but how do we make sure that it doesn't affect performance or site security? That's where we see continuous accessibility coming in as a game changer. You'll have everything in your control. You'll have quality gate checks done immediately. It's very similar in that way to automated testing. For the DevOps people and CTOs in the room, here's the bottom line. Doing accessibility right saves you money. So even if you have a full team that does nothing but accessibility, keeping up with changing regulations and technology, you can now integrate it into your pipeline, into your process. And I hope you do. Making your website accessible isn't just about avoiding that worst UI hall of shame or being the subject of one of my jokes in a future talk. If you do it right, it's not just good karma, it's good business. So I would encourage you to take a holistic approach with automation to take care of systemic issues and pockets of inaccessibility. My company, UserWay, happens to make an AI code fixer and a CI/CD tool for continuous accessibility. And if you happen to choose to work with us, I would be delighted. Or if you want to talk nerdy to me, stop by our booth. We're UserWay, and I'm Sophia Tupolev-Luz. Thank you. And I just want to give it up for Tamara, who interpreted my whole talk. Thank you. Both good jokes and bad. That was great. Thank you so much.
All right, thank you.